Yeah, how do you calculate volume? Okay, so the general expression what we derived in the earlier class was T equal to C A naught integral 0 to x a d x a by minus r a, yeah, for constant system. Otherwise, it is 1 plus yeah, so that v equal to v naught, I think that also we will discuss later. So, this is the general expression. If it is constant volume, then epsilon equal to 0. Okay. So, that is why this becomes 1 and this becomes simply minus r a. So, then here we do not have specifically volume coming out from the rate, I mean the design expression. Whereas, if you derive later, because you know already, that is why I am telling. So, you already seen that for mixed flow reactor and plug flow reactor, you get volume as V by F A naught equal to, right. So, for similarity, I will also write this one as T by C A naught equal to 0 to x A d x A by minus r A, general I think, you know, for constant systems let us say, right. So, T by C A naught, this is the general expression for a batch reactor which you are supposed to remember all the time. Okay. But what we have been thinking was that this T or this equation does not contain volume, but finally, we have to design the volume of the batch reactor. How do you calculate volume? What do you know before starting all this reactor design? So, do you have any information? You just remember that our diagram. Production means your F A naught supposed to be, if it is a flow rate, okay. But here there is no flow, but still you know what is the production rate. Okay. You know what is the production rate. Let me tell you just I think for simplicity, I have to produce production rate, I have to produce 24 tons per day, right. So, I could have divided, you know, I would have calculated per year how much I have to produce, then per day I calculated, I got 24 tons per day. And 24 I have taken because easy for calculations, right? Yeah. But my this design expression will not tell me what is the volume required to produce 24 tons per day. How do I calculate what is the volume of the reactor from this information, 24 tons per day and time? C A naught I know. Okay, that area under the curve I will, this area under the curve I will evaluate. And then find what is T. Yeah, that is what I did, no amount of from conversion, let us say for 90% conversion if I take, or 99% conversion, this equation gives me only time, correct, no, that area under the curve when I take, I have to take either 99% conversion, 95% conversion or so, whatever, because you know that from 95 to 99, okay, let me also draw that. This general shape only we are, general shape only I am just drawing. So, normally you will get most of the time like this, and here you see why it is steeply increasing.
1 by minus r a.
What is r a at x equal to 1? At 100% conversion,
there is no rate.
What is r mathematically?
0.
But what is this coordinate? 1 by?
Infinity.
We have to go to infinity. And now just imagine before that, it is not 1, 0.99999, then you are very close to infinity, right. So, that is why if you now come back a little bit slowly down this way, then you know that lot of area increase will be there in this region, whereas here I will not have that much increase. That is where the economics in designing the reactor will come, because I may go to 99.499999. Okay. I need very large volume when compared to 99.9929s. There will be tremendous difference between these two. So, that means only to produce 0.09, okay, 0.9949s, only I have taken 2 9s now. So, then you will have 0.01. So, to produce that small amount, then I have to go for very big volume. No engineer will do like that. You able to follow me or you able to follow me, no? Because 0.99, 0.999, 0.999, every time when you are moving one decimal, your volume also not 10 times increasing, it is sometimes 100 times increasing, because it is very steep, going to infinity. Okay, here, and theoretically speaking, when 0.9999, if you put 100 nines, then you get infinity. Again, my same thing, if you have infinite volume, you cannot operate the reactor, because entire universe is only one reactor, your reactor. So, that is the reason why always you have to design whether you have to decide what is the economically viable volume or conversion. Conversion only gives you that volume, right. So, that means you have to decide, okay, now 99% is fine with me, conversion, right. So, that is why conversion is always coming there. So, I am now taking till here, let us say, okay, that may be 0.99 or may be 0.98. Right, as an engineer you have to find out which is the viable one. Okay, so this is XA final. So, knowing this information, let me say that, okay, I will also give you this area under the curve T by CA naught, and even if I take, I know CA some value. So, the T is, let us say, 7 hours. Now, you tell me, how do I calculate? That means to produce, I don't know how much amount now, because batch will not tell you what is the amount you have to produce. Whether you take 1 kilo, 1 ton, 100 tons, time is same. That is the beauty with this reactor. But now you have to find out what is the volume depending on production, rate. Okay? Can you guess? You have to also try to imagine, maybe a wrong imagination also no problem for us. You should be able to imagine and then tell us that, sir, this is what I am thinking. If it is wrong, I will tell you. If it is right, I know I will appreciate you. Sir, even if you tell wrong, I do not scold you. Okay. Yeah.
Multiplying production rate with time.
With the time? Okay. What do I get when I multiply 7 into 24?
Mass.
So, I am getting that tons only, so 24 tons. 24 into 7 tons. 7 hours. That is the only time you use for calculation?
Between two batches.
Yeah. You have other timings also, first of all, you have to take into account. That is why we say that this is what is called TRX. That is only reaction time. See, the total batch time, T batch, will be TRXN reaction time plus. See, you have to first charge when you are first starting the reaction, right, that charging time. Then after the reaction you have discharging time, and again sometimes you may have to clean. So, cleaning time, all those timings also will come into picture. You know, particularly biochemical reactions, they use sterilization time, otherwise next microorganisms may die. Okay, and I told you batch reactors we choose because we also have that flexibility in products. So, the earlier products may contaminate the present batch. So, that is why I have to clean it there. So, all those timings will come into picture. That is T, loading, charging, okay, CH, and also you have T discharge, DCH, plus T cleaning, anything else? Generally these things. Okay, all the timing should be known to us, but here we can have some kind of optimization. If your operators are very good, very efficient people, then probably this, all these things will be in 1 hour you can finish. Okay, or if there are very, very lazy people, then it may take 2 hours. So, okay, so because if you do not have particularly automation and all that, if you have automation, then you are replacing humans with machines. Machines are always efficient when compared to humans. Okay. So, I mean in doing general work, okay, day to day work, but when you want to use brain, humans are the greatest. Okay, so that is there. So all this is 1 hour and this is 7 hours. So now I have total batch time 8 hours. Okay, so now what we do is I have to now produce 24 tons per day, but I have now 8 hours per batch. Okay, yeah, how many batches we can now take?
3 batches.
Okay, so now when I have 3 batches, okay, so in this case 3 batches, number of 3. So now per batch how many tons? Yeah, per batch we have now 24 by 3 tons per day. So sorry, no, 3 batches and each batch will have 8 tons. This is tons only, 8 tons. Okay, now how do I put this, how do I now calculate the volume? Yeah, you know the density of the reaction mixture. Okay, so when you have that density of reaction mixture, 8 tons, let us say water, you now tell me what is the volume. I have exactly like water, like reaction mixture,
8 meter cube,
because 1 ton per 1 meter cube. Yeah, 1 meter cube, 1000 kgs, no, 1000 kg per meter cube, right? So that means 1 ton per meter cube. So I have to have now 8 meter cube volume, and our problem is not yet over. This 8 meter cube volume I have, how do I now put that one as a physical reactor? That means you should have some diameter and some length. That comes later, but how do I put this? What is the shape? Because if I am a crazy fellow, I can take 1 nanometer and length, because 8 meter cube I can put anyway, no? Now you can calculate what is the length. I think it goes to Mars or maybe Jupiter or beyond that. That is not engineering, okay? We know that. Then what is what else? I can take diameter of the earth and then calculate height. What will be the height? 0. So again, where do you put? So what is logical now? Engineering logical, huh? Ah, what is thumb rule?
Like
L by D equal to what?
L
by D, I am asking L by D, because L by D you have to fix. Two extremes I told, you can take 1 nanometer, almost 0, and then length you can calculate, not practical. You can take diameter of the earth and then also calculate height. The diameter of the earth is equivalent to your tank diameter. Okay, so then you can calculate height, okay, that is also 0. So these two are not engineering solutions. So what is engineering solution for fixing L by D? He says 0.75, he says 2, why do you say 2? I will also ask him. Ah, yeah, she says, Pooja says 1.
You should choose such an L by D where the reactor surface area is
minimum. You can never have that kind of thing, no, because surface area per unit volume, only sphere has minimum. So all our reactors are
ideally
should not be. So our reactors are cylindrical.
As the L by D ratio changes, non-ideality increases.
What non-ideality?
Dead zones.
So what?
Mixing
okay, they happen. What will happen?
Conversion will be affected.
Why conversion changes if dead zones are there?
One proper mixing will not take place. Some portion of the reactor won't mix.
How do you avoid that?
Mixing.
Stirring. So now fluid mechanics again will tell you, generally for L by D equal to 1, you have good mixing. See, when you have this tank, so when you put this kind of thing, L by D equal to approximately 1, one stirrer is enough. And when you go to L by D equal to 2, then you know, sometimes you also sit a scene like this, right? So general thumb rule is, for each L by D you need one type of blade. You know, normally you have so many things. You have propeller type stirrers, you have turbine type stirrers, anchor type stirrers, all these things are there. So, we know approximately in all these things L by D equal to 1 will give me good mixing. That means, in this case I should see everywhere uniform concentration and temperature. Even if I take L by D equal to 2, many times you will take L by D equal to 2, okay. You know, you would have seen batch reactors, but it is not L by D equal to 1 most of the time. It is L by D equal to 2 many times, 3 rarely. That means, you know, stirring is not that efficient, but L by D equal to 1.5 also is common. But criteria is that this L by D should be such that your mixing should not be sacrificed. Mixing should be perfect. That is the engineering rule. Okay? So, now I think I am able to make, you know, some clarity where you have to remember these simple things. They are not complicated. We are not really discussing that kind of complicated where we will get Nobel Prize. No one will give us Nobel Prize for his, you know, when you take L by D equal to 1. Okay? But we should know why we are taking L by D equal to 1. Right? So, if someone asks, okay, I think, you know, why did you say 0.75?
Because if there is a, that is, the remedial sign, the maximum most you can stand. So, just
have to
practically guess.
Why standing? I think standing depends on our structure, where you know, you put that legs and all that.
Bottom of the area is high,
it
will be better to…
No, cylinders only, no? Cylinders, most of the time you go for cylinders. Okay, which size you go, other than cylinders, you tell me. Why again, that is also engineering question. Why do you go most of the time for cylinders rather than spheres? Very difficult to fabricate, very difficult to construct. Okay? So, that much again we do not want to spend our time and all that. Simple thing is take a big, like this, yeah, like this a sheet and then fold it. Put one thing here, put another thing there, not permanently because you have to charge and all that. No? So, that is all, that is very simple. Because engineers will think, as I told you, in a simplest manner. That is the reason why we have to, oh my god, okay. So, this is what. So, now you know how to calculate volume of the thing. I will give you a problem, maybe I will upload or maybe tomorrow I will give on a piece of paper and then distribute to you. You solve that problem. It is a very good problem, but it is a reversible reaction, because now you know this R, it can be either irreversible reaction or it can be reversible reaction with some orders or without order. All kinds of complicated equations can come. So, that is why, because you already exposed to this subject, I will give you one problem tomorrow. You solve and tell me the answer. If you are not getting, I will tell you the answer. Because on your own doing, I think you will really understand everything. Okay?